Editor's note. This video is satirical, and although I make jokes, I don't intend to downplay the seriousness of cancer. With that being said, here's the video. Everywhere you look nowadays, you see news, studies, articles about how meat gives you cancer, plastic gives you cancer, shit, even cancer gives you cancer. I feel like we're looking at it through a one-sided lens. What about the people who actually want to get cancer? Today, we're going to be looking at the people who have dedicated themselves to carcinogen maxing. This is a somewhat newer phenomenon that exploded in popularity following some 4chan posts about carcinogen maxing. In a thread about pizza toppings, one anon says that his favourite way to eat pizza is eating them completely burnt. He says that it doesn't really taste that great, but they're carcinogenic so they get the job done. Another anon asks, what is carcinogen maxing? And the original replies, he is min-maxing his food consumption to increase his carcinogen intake to eventually contract cancer. If you look into the science of eating burnt foods, anon is correct that they do give you cancer, and it's to do with the burnt food containing carbon-free radicals that can ionize cells and create cancerous cells. Now that I've explained what carcinogen maxing is, you might be wondering how you, the dear viewer, can partake in carcinogen maxing. We're going to be looking at several methods of carcinogen maxing, starting with cigarettes. Everyone's vaping nowadays. Everywhere you look, you walk past a group of gangsters and all you can smell is blueberry muffins. What happened to real men that were blowing literal poison clouds every time they took a drag? I suggest we bring back smoking and let the public have a breath of not so fresh air again. Is all the money there? Good. I'll make sure to say something nice about ciggies in the next video. And did your boss tell you about the super donation pack? I'm going to advocate for reducing the smoking age to zero. Why let children have secondhand smoke when they can have the real thing, am I right? Did you hear that? Hey, who's there? Shit, it's the feds. You didn't see a goddamn thing. Now, for those of you carcinogen maxing, smoking a pack a day is a good place to start, but it's still going to take you about 20 years or more before you start seeing real results. The fastest known way to carcinogen max is to age rapidly. The likelihood of cancer development is like 1,000 times more likely when comparing 18 to 25 year olds, which is the majority of my audience, and 65 year olds. But because this is impossible for now at least, the next best way to carcinogen max is to become horribly, morbidly obese. The cancer rate skyrockets as excess weight piles on, so you're going to want to increase your caloric intake by drinking seed oils. This is especially true if you're also burnt food maxing, as the burnt food will have less calories than normal as some of the energy is used up in combustion. Even using all these methods in combination, you will still only increase your chances by a couple percentage points, especially in the first few months and years. So if you think about the chance of getting cancer as rolling a 1 million sided dice that you throw every day, and smoking adds an extra side that gives you cancer, you're still looking at a long time before your carcinogen maxing sees you any results. This is one of the main issues for carcinogen maxers. It's that you can't just inject yourself with cancer either, because your immune system will just destroy them quickly. So what do you do if you want to carcinogen max as efficiently as possible? There's only one known solution to this dilemma, and it's not easy to acquire. Weapons-grade plutonium. That being said, does it have to be weapons-grade? Probably not. Does it have to be plutonium? Also, probably not. But it just rolls off the tongue nicely. But yes, radioactive material is the fast-track method that anyone can do. It's just a matter of finding a sufficient energy source that, although difficult, is not impossible given the fact that one guy in Florida managed to find an unexploded nuclear weapon and use it as an energy source until the feds came and kicked his door down, that is. So now you have the radioactive material. You can administer it in a number of ways, such as intravenously or via demon core exposure, but a good old cup of tea is the easiest way. Isn't that right, Vladimir? Actually, I lied. Between me and you, if you want cancer instantly, just queue 5 games of League of Legends. And if you don't have cancer by the end of it, you should probably go out and buy a few lottery tickets. If you want to add me in game, here's my summoner name. But if you're a pisslo, don't add me. I've already got cancer.
I think I cancer maxed just a little hard. But if you like the video, consider subscribing and maybe hitting the like button. But thanks for watching. Bye.